Hey, allihopa. Welcome to On the John. Valkman. I am very excited because there is a new season of Allt För Sverige and season 11. Allt För Sverige, for those of you that don't know, is a Swedish reality TV program. I was on season 10 last year, was the runner-up, and it is one of the best programs being made right now. It's incredible, and I know I'm biased because I was on it, but truly, it's a beautiful show where Americans and Canadians of Swedish descent return to Sweden, for the first time. They go to Sweden, and you trace your family ancestry all over the country, and you get to look at the differences and the similarities between cultures. You get to discover things about yourself, things about your family history, things about your genealogy you had no idea. It is life-changing for those that get to be on it. And it's jokingly known over there as the show with the crying Americans. I certainly cried a lot all over the country. And I'm not mad about it because it was incredibly impactful. I'm not the same person, and it really changed the course of my life and my family's trajectory. I'll forever be grateful for it. We'll talk about that in another episode, but full disclosure, I've seen this episode, but I'm excited to watch it again and take in and sort of, the first time was sort of a blur because it was with a cast party, so I'm excited to watch it by myself and relive some of this.
I think part of me has always been looking for a sense of home.
There you go, buddy.
It's just always been this magical place where we're from.
It feels like it's lacking, like I'm dehydrated, like I haven't had my water.
I'm glad to say you are going to Sweden.
Are you serious?
What?
This moment is crazy. I just cried, then I called my dad, then I screamed. That feeling right there.
Oh, sorry to curse you.
Are you kidding?
Yes.
Oh my God.
That's so sweet.
I know this is going to change the whole trajectory of my life.
Yep.
You're winning.
Yeah, I'm going to win.
You have no idea.
I know I'm going to walk into this, and then the next time I come out, I'm going to be different.
All right, rock and roll. Looking forward to this trip.
Oh, look at that smile. Gonna miss you,
baby. Oh, I have this need to figure myself out. I don't know what made me. I don't know what broke me sometimes.
At 70 years old, I realized that I won't have the opportunity again. I just won't.
Wow. 10 svensk-amerikaner är på väg mot sitt livs äventyr. De ska återvända till landet de fantiserat om, längtat till.
Man,
look at that view. Look at it.
Wow, this view is incredible.
In Sweden,
they probably walk through right here into the front door.
Som deras förfäder en gång lämnade i hopp om ett bättre liv.
It's terrible. So heartbreaking. I had absolutely no idea.
This is truly a key to the past. My past.
På sin resa genom Sverige ska de tävla mot varandra tills bara vinnaren står kvar. Redo att återförenas med sin svenska släkt.
It's a royalty right there.
I came here to win and meet my family. It's as simple as that.
My family is my world. And to be able to bring more people into that family
is
such an incredible thought.
Just had the most incredible experience. I'm so excited to watch this whole season.
We got this. We got this.
I have so many feelings about what's going on right now. It's a mixture of emotion and
I can't help
anticipation.
Oh, wow. We'll watch this and think about all the camera shots. They guarantee you had to walk
this
dream
of finding out who our family is,
15 times.
What our family did, how our family did it.
Get the close shot.
That's our family history.
The wide picture. drone shots.
It doesn't feel
they
real.
Stitch it together no, so no. well. Hats off
like
to
a dream.
The
it feels like
camera
a dream.
Crew
like we're right there, finally.
And the editors.
I've been wanting to do this since I was a kid. I think it's just gonna be like a,
so
like a
much
weight
footage.
Is lifted off me, you know.
I'm going home. I always have wanted to reconnect, and because of circumstances in my life, I wasn't able. I wasn't emotionally healthy and financially able, and I just didn't have the ability to communicate with extended family about my family.
Okay, we got it.
We got you.
Yeah, let's do this, guys. Mm. You got this.
Oh, you're going home.
We're all going home.
All right, that's the first walk.
Oh my gosh, it's right there.
You can't describe how emotional it is.
It's like when you're a child and you wake up on Christmas morning and you're wondering what gifts you're gonna get. I'm gonna be unwrapping Sweden and seeing how much of it is mine.
Three, two, one.
I love it.
Congratulations, man. This is the show. Love this boat ride.
I can't believe how great it's going to be. This is the beginning of an adventure, the adventure of a lifetime.
Hello!
Hello!
Yay! Andrews is the best,
the border?
By the way.
Yes!
Okay.
Such a good
excited?
Human.
Yes! Good. Welcome.
Thank you.
Crossing
That's
the bridge.
A great shot.
Isn't that
right
a great symbolic way to start the journey that lays ahead of you.
Yes.
It is. Crossing a bridge in dreams, that could mean connecting two different worlds. And you're about to do that. Connecting past with present. Dan, if we had been standing here in October 1922, looking over the sea, you might have seen the steamship Oscar II leaving Oslo Harbor. And you would have waved. Aboard was Anna Elvira Högberg and Erik Andersson André. They were your mother's, father's, mother's parents.
Yeah.
You would have waved. This coastline was the last they saw of Sweden.
You almost can't describe how powerful this moment is. To be standing in the place, and I think it's the physicality of being there and being told this story, and they do such a great job of explaining these narratives of your family and the past and what they went through, and you're just taking it, it just hits you so hard. And every single one of these people loves the country of Sweden, and they've never been there before. And so you're just, it's this huge emotional high roller coaster that it's really special. This is really fun to
ever.
Watch. Wow.
So they would have waved back. Yeah. Happy to see that finally one of their descendants made it back home.
It's a blessing.
Yeah.
I felt like I was learning something, but it was the beginning of a movie. I have the rest of the movie to watch.
And Billy, in late March,
Billy from Indianapolis,
young boy, 18 years old, brown hair, blue eyes, with $10 in his pocket, and with a stiff finger on his left hand, left from Gothenburg Harbor. It's only 30 miles south from here. His name was Kunnig Karlsson, and he was your mother's mother's father. He was known to be a troublemaker.
Imagine that.
You can? He left Sweden on this steamship, Ariosto. And Kirsten.
Hi.
In 1891, three generations of women from the same family, Anna Johan's daughter, with her mother, Inger, and her daughter, Emma, they left Sweden on Ariosto. Anna Johan's daughter was your father's 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 mother. She was married. But there's no husband
so hard,
recorded
so
on the script.
So good.
You want to hear the rest of the story?
I do, yeah. I do feel a little overwhelmed. Three generations of women of like mothers holding daughters, and like that's how it all starts. I'm just so excited to learn more and have new connections.
So, a long time ago, your ancestors, they set out on a journey that change the course and destiny of generations to come. And you are about to close a circle, to return to the places where everything started.
So crazy.
And for one of you, this journey will take you all the way to a family reunion. Welcome home!
Yeah, I forgot to mention that. So the grand prize is
to
find all your Swedish
experience
family,
started, because once it starts, probably not going to stop. I might not leave Sweden. You might tell me to leave. I might not go.
Really beautiful.
Come on, get out of here. Let's get going.
Love it. Love it, love it, love it. So many memories. Oh, my goodness.
Pictures of that.
What is that?
Okay,
stuff?
So this
know.
Is good.
It's so bright.
I wonder, it looks
they
like sapphire.
They did not
to
film
me.
Us much in the car.
I feel excited, nervous.
Yeah, we always
I don't
said,
know what's
like,
next,
they missed
but
so
at this
much
point,
good footage.
You know, I'm just ready to let go. And
we just had a big sing along.
I'm here. I'm going to be here for the adventure, whatever comes.
Those car rides were some of the best.
Stick around, that'll change.
Moments.
Yeah, I know.
Just so good.
Shopping carts.
Luckily, we took
a lot.
Go carts, so we had our own footage. Had to make a
when we drove in here, I didn't know what to expect, and I was just thinking, like, are we gonna sleep here? What's gonna happen?
Oh my gosh!
This is so exciting. I kind of want to just join this family and just settle in for a while. Hello.
This is so funny because you're walking by.
The first impression of
this
place,
people that
beautiful.
Are camping, but there's
nature
there's
being immersed in nature with the birds
over,
chirping,
guys
the birds chirping
mics,
here
it
in
is
Sweden
a,
versus in America.
Production.
It's like their vocal cords are completely different.
Oh my goodness.
What's in it?
What's in the box?
Hoffert's.
Brad Pitt.
Okay, guys, I wonder what's inside. Who's ready? Who's going to open it?
I think Billy's got it.
I got it?
Yeah, come on.
Hey.
I'm so thrilled to finally open up a Hoffert. I feel like this is what my great-grandfather brought across the Atlantic, and I just want to know what's inside.
Yeah, legit, all of our ancestors would have carried one of those with all their belongings.
T-shirts, a beer, keys, a Swedish dictionary, record player.
Swedish goodies. Goodies.
First thing that caught my eye, and it was probably...
Oh, we should
it was
steal
the beer.
That for America.
All right,
goodies.
Mike's going to read us a letter
all right.
here.
All right, Mike. Oh, Mike. Dear Americans, or should I say... Cara Americana.
Dear Americans.
Before
Americans.
You is a familiar object, the America Coffert, the very symbol of the great migration west that over a 50-year period uprooted one-fifth of the Swedish population. The America Coffert is a symbol of a fresh start as well as one of definite farewells. This is the kind of coffert that your ancestors used to pack all that they thought they would need for a new life yep. on a new and unknown continent. However, now it's filled with items to make sure your Swedish adventure will be a truly great one. You are now at the most frequently visited tourist destination in Sweden, Ullared, the place where Swedes love to go to spend both time and money. So rest assured that you share this upcoming experience with practically every Swedish citizen in the country. Everybody has an opinion about Ullared. It's time for you to form one of your own. So let's go down the rabbit hole and explore.
I'd say I'm a little surprised this is the most visited Swedish tourist destination.
Right now I'm just seeing RVs, and so it's hard to like wrap my mind around it being the most visited tourist destination.
I definitely think there's gonna be a little more to this. There's gotta be, right?
Have a great first night in Sweden, and see you tomorrow. Anders.
What's that?
Pretty fun.
What is that? That looks kind of like a nut.
What?
Castine.
Is this going to be some sort of like hallucinogenic psychedelic experience? I'm a little afraid.
Oh, that's a... Oh, I don't know about that.
Oh, no, this is a bad experience.
There is a hard candy with a very distinctive taste.
Oh.
Which one?
What is this?
Oh, I like the salty ones. The salty licorice.
These candies. These are death.
Yeah.
This is something you take those and you are... You're spitting, you're cross-eyed, you don't know where you're going.
This is the worst stuff.
Right.
I can't describe it, but it's not something that I would like to possibly do again.
Now it's time for some music. It doesn't look like ABBA.
I love the music. It was so fun. It had a great beat to it. I was like, okay.
We really liked the song.
We should make a song like that.
Kind of had like a Cotton Eye Joe feel. It was really fun.
It was so nice to listen to the music and actually dance with everyone. I think we're all so excited to be here to let that energy out and to dance to Swedish music was amazing.
Yeah. So much energy on that first day. What an adventure.
Is there one here?
Oh, they're so right.
Nice. They're cute.
What number is this?
This is number one.
So this will probably be for the guys.
Yes, yeah. This has three people, so me, you, and
okay,
Mike.
Okay, Daniel and I had a shared experience.
You want to go find ours?
Yeah, okay,
let's go.
I did my special day, get back
five,
late, everybody's right. Sleeping.
This is, oh my god,
all,
this is so cute.
There's like three of us in one of those little fugas.
I think it's gonna look really cute in there.
Which those are great, fun little experience.
After you, age before
fun
beauty,
experience.
There you go.
There was some snoring in my
I'm gonna climb
my fuga.
I'm gonna
so I did
like
not sleep
baby.
The entire first night.
I see a bunk down there. The cabin's definitely
I guess
pretty
it was the second
small.
Night.
This is not made for people my size.
It wasn't made for 6'2", 300 plus pound individuals climbing up ladders to lofts, getting into bunk beds.
Cozy.
Oh yeah.
I might pull one of those and put them on the floor because it's so tight.
Amazing. Welcome to my house. Baby, take control
now. We can't even slow down. I have to turn the music down for copyright.
We have a little party on our porch.
Oh my gosh, this is so cute.
My cabin is so cool. I mean, we can fit six people in there, so we could totally have a slumber party with all the girls if we wanted.
My goodness.
I like mini houses.
Welcome to my house. It's my house.
Could you imagine if we lived in this, like, all the time?
I love the feeling it's giving me right now.
Well, the sun is shining on you right now, so let me tell you something. You're doing something right.
Hey.
The deck of the cabin is probably the most welcoming feature. In some areas in the United States, you don't have the luxury of being on your porch in the middle of the forest and being able to wave at people as they go by.
Hi!
Hey!
How do you like your place?
It's so cute!
It's
so cute!
Being able to have that communication with somebody who you don't know, and they might come up and have a conversation with you.
Hey, let's see what else they have around
yeah.
here. I want to go for a tour.
Yeah, let's do it.
Do it.
And we will follow you, Billy.
Oh, great.
Hello, how are you?
Hello.
Hi, I'm Carl.
Hi, my name is Paul.
Nice to meet you.
That is Jan.
Hi, nice to meet you. What is this? Have you been coming here often?
Yes, because of the, we are buying things in Ullared. Yeah. And we are buying for a lot of money.
Oh, yeah, look at this.
it's cheap here.
Hey. I love it when you say hey and they don't turn around. We are in Sweden.
Maybe they like they don't say hi to strangers. They listen to their mother.
I guess as Americans we're just friendly and open. So if you see somebody and you're passing somebody in the street,
the
you just say,
problem
oh,
is
hello,
all
good
the
evening.
Cameras behind
hey.
You.
Hey.
And some people
and so
just don't.
We tried to wave and they just looked at us and I think they thought we were crazy.
They almost were shaking their heads like,
there's cameras and
no hellos. Nobody wanted to talk to me.
I guarantee if you walked up.
Loud. Yeah, maybe we try again. Somebody's going to say hi to us.
You could have a conversation.
Yeah.
What are you sipping on in there?
I've heard.
These are the first Swedish people that I've met
some
on my journey that I've interacted with.
Too happy
you
about.
Want to taste?
I would love to have a sample.
Yeah,
that'd
be great.
Thank you. It's pretty welcoming. Like hearing them say, hey, would you like some wine? It's like, of course I would.
Cheers.
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 And we can spark a little conversation
so friendly,
about where they're
so
from.
Nice.
It's cool
love
to
it.
Hear their culture.
Mm, and right. that's a good that's experience, cool. too.
Oh, that's very
because
good.
They were speaking of this factory where
means
they,
you so
spend
much
like
to you.
10,000, 15,000 crowns
local Swedes,
on furniture, clothes, food,
and share some
whatever.
Wine,
and
share some conversation.
I was like, I've never heard of anything like that before. There's nothing like
really
that in
good,
America.
Really good moment.
Do you want some more?
No,
it's
no,
good.
No.
Just put a nipple on that.
Some people just try a different tactic, and then you
start walking with your head down.
Yeah, be a little quieter.
But that's part of the culture, is there are differences between how people relate in different areas of the world, so.
I don't know if it's like not being like friendly, though. I kind of think that it is just like, you know, you need a little softer approach.
Maybe it's the way you approach people. We're just, I think, as Americans, we're kind of be loud, maybe a little obnoxious.
We could just wave at this car. Hey.
What if we wave?
Hey, car. Hey.
Hi. Yes. And he has a dog in the back.
The dog people are much more friendlier.
We finally have people that wave back.
You just don't have that friendly demeanor that we have. I don't know what to tell you.
What are you talking about? I'm from Indiana. We're all friendly.
Okay.
We appreciate your time. We love Sweden. We will. Yeah. And we'll definitely come back here and tell you about it.
Yes.
Thank you. Take care. Thank you.
Thank you. What a nice guy.
That was awesome.
This is awesome. This is perfect. What a great first day.
It is. It's been wonderful.
Tons of emotions. Already. Can you believe it?
You are much better at this than I am. It's almost like you have, like, children.
I know. I have children who have small little beds that need to be... Not anymore, but they used to.
I feel like I'm going in a loop. Like...
Are you?
Oh, because I am. It's like a giant bag.
Oh, you have the duvet cover.
Okay. Oh.
Normally we don't have duvets with duvet covers, so we were wondering, do we just sleep in this sheet like a sleeping bag? But then we put the blanket on top. So we figured it out.
So smart.
There we go.
Blankets go in the duvet cover in Sweden. So it's like a sheet and your blanket.
My name is Lillian Knudsen. I am 50 years old. I have three children. My husband and I have been married for 26 years, and we have a great life in Charlotte, North Carolina.
Hi, sweetie.
Hi.
I grew up in Canada, and I've known about my Swedish roots my whole life because my parents are very proud of their Swedish heritage. We even lived in a town called Swedeville. This is what it was called because of all the Swedish people who settled there. So you can imagine it was a lot easier to preserve your heritage in a place where everyone around you was also Swedish.
I work from home and I'm an entrepreneur. So I've launched a few products. My favorite thing to do is to be creative.
It started out with a baby product that then became, you know, a menstrual cup that I wanted to make better. And then it was a lip balm kit so kids could have, you know, fun during COVID.
With these products, I was able to be creative and take them from an idea all the way to market.
So as I've grown up and as I've kind of come to know who I am, my Swedish heritage has become more important to me. And the reason I want to do this now is because it's the perfect time in my life to have this adventure. My children are at an age where they're more independent. I sold a lot of my company off. It's really a time that I can just explore my identity and who I am. I think of it like as an adoption, like when you want to find your biological mother and you've spent your whole life with your family and then you're like, well, but who am I really? Like,
a lot of respect for
my biological mother. Would I recognize her? Would there be something similar?
Cool.
And it's kind of like
that.
I was adopted by Canada, but my biological mother is Sweden and I would love to get to know her and see if we recognize each other. So I have Swedish roots on both my mom and my dad's side. My great-grandpa was Sami, and they left Tärnaby. I don't know if they were being persecuted or if they were feeling maybe that they didn't belong. I'm not sure. But it seemed like they were desperate to leave. I am very ready to open the chest, and I just hope that it... You know what? I don't hope anything. It's not a hope chest. It's a family chest, and I'm ready to meet my family.
This experience is so powerful right here.
Dear Lillian, welcome to Sapmi, where your ancestors, the Samis, lived for thousands of years in the rhythms of the earth, hunting, fishing, and herding reindeer on these lands that they held sacred.
I just read it and cried.
Johan Nilsson was born in 1849 in
Tarnafors,
where his parents had become pioneering farmers.
Tragedy struck when fate made him the only child at six. His only sibling, Anna Maya, passed away from an unknown illness at the age of 12.
The family then moved to a new settlement called Frakenvik, where Johan spent his formative years. Unfortunately, in 1868...
This is such a gift, too, because they craft such a great story about your family that you didn't know. and reading it in the place, you know, you're on the same ground that these people walked, and they just bring them to life in a way that just dates on a paper just wouldn't do justice.
Johan's life took a darker turn when he became involved in the theft of seven reindeer worth a total of 84 riksdaler. However, it's obvious that Johan acted to keep his family alive during a severe famine caused by a frost that destroyed much of Sweden's harvest. This region was amongst the worst hit. Some folks here got so desperate they resorted to eating their shoes. I can't even imagine. I'm so sad. It's so horrible. Even so, 19-year-old Johan was sentenced to 18 months hard labor for his crime, plus 8 long years probation. It seems unfair if he was doing it to feed his family. In prison, he was a model citizen. Johan was released 3 months early in June 1869 and returned to his home in Frackenvik. In 1872, he married Sigrid Olofsdottir, 10 years his senior. Wow. They had 2 sons, but only one survived to adulthood. The small family moved to Rönnback in 1897 and became tenant farmers. They devoted their extra space to those in need of shelter. Among these were a mentally ill pauper, a widow, and a 23-year-old named Matilda Magnusdottir, along with her illegitimate daughter, Hulda. Wow, I know this is Matilda because I can tell by the face. Your great-grandmother, Matilda, as a young woman. When Matilda had another child out of wedlock 1 year later, in 1902, scandalous rumors spread, saying that the master of the house himself was the father. Where there's smoke, there's fire, of course. Whatever excuse Johan gave to obtain his exit papers from Tärna Parish in 1903 was likely a lie. According to your family lore, Johan and Matilda were caught up in a whirlwind love story in which they took a leaky rowboat as far as they could, then continued by foot to Norway, where they boarded a coastal boat to the nearest port.
That's crazy.
Their story is perhaps romanticized, but the church registry confirms that Matilda eloped with Johan and their child, Hjalmar, on August 12th, 1903, but that they left her daughter, Hulda, behind.
120 years ago.
This is Hulda.
Man, that's crazy.
That Matilda left behind. She looks maybe a teenager here.
And how do people do that?
I don't understand. It would be so hard to leave your child. Oh, man. Hulda Augusta, Eric's daughter. My grandpa, who I love very much, that would have been his older sister. I feel she's resting in peace, finally.
It's really powerful to go to these grave
sites. Hulda died childless in Sweden, marking the end of that branch of the family.
On our return trip
on August 27th, 1903, Johan and Matilda arrived in Montreal aboard the ship Lake Simcoe, which had sailed from Liverpool. Matilda traveled under the name Rangild and used false papers to arrange for a ticket, a tactic commonly used by runaways. Johan and Matilda inaugurated a new life for themselves in Waterville, Quebec, where they proceeded to have 9 more children. This is Johan and Matilda with their 3 firstborn, Hjalmar, Hulda, and John. It's interesting, she had a Hulda back home and she named a daughter Hulda. Johan's abandoned wife, Sigrid, passed away back here in Sweden. While in America, Johan and Matilda's son, Frank, was born. He would become your grandfather. Matilda had several brothers in her home village. One of them was named Christopher, and he built this very house where you can now pick up the traces left behind. He built the house here. Even though it's been redone, it's still the same structure and the same foundation as the original house. So that was so
powerful and meaningful to me. So I just thought I would walk up the steps to the house. And then I looked just to my left and I saw a sign. Well, it was like a pelt. And I thought, well, that's interesting. And I saw all these names signed on it. What? Wait. My Uncle Richard. Richard Nilsson. It's my uncle.
That's cool.
It's important
That's
to take
really
the time
cool.
to make sure that the connections to your roots are in good order.
1986. Wow.
I had absolutely no idea that my Uncle Richard had been here. They signed this. I guess this is the guest book. So I signed my name and a little message underneath my Uncle Richard's. Super special. The best thing ever. Family will always find a way to bridge the distance. Lillian Barbro Knutsen.
Love it. Nicely done.
This whole experience has done me a world of good. I don't even think I can put it into words right now. I'm very emotional. It was a very
cool
intensely
shot.
Emotional experience.
That is
We've carried
such
these
an
stories
awesome
down, and
nice,
it hasn't been
nice
that
job.
Far back in the generations. So these stories are fresh and real, and
a
now they've come to life for me.
Cameraman
so
really
it puts
cared
a whole new perspective,
about
the art. And I appreciate this so much.
It's beautiful.
It's a beautiful day for me to rock around your way.
Okay, so that happened to me. I had to take the mattress outside.
My first night
outside.
Swedish camping was incredible. I feel like I've woken up with the birds. I feel like I'm starting
somebody.
To embrace this place. Like, I could
Although
stay
I
after camping for the whole month.
Like 4:30 in the morning. I don't know what time it was, but I look up and there's like a wolf or a coyote or something that's just
yeah.
come through. Much
24
more wolfy
hours
looking
of
than
exhaustion.
A dog.
And water.
Drink your water. Right.
So
it
can cold,
be exciting.
Too.
Exciting and healing.
Absolutely.
Mm. Well, I think they had warmer weather.
Great morning, man. The sun is just
summer.
Hanging
summer.
In the sky.
Yeah, I think we're getting too spoiled on the Swedish weather. I'm waiting for the disaster to
Well,
come.
I told
yeah,
you
we
yesterday
were
I brought
freezing,
this weather
filming.
From California.
There
just
you go.
For us.
See, yeah, this is absolutely yeah. your vibe. Yeah.
Hey, guys.
Hey, man. Good
morning,
hey,
Daniel.
I woke up last night. You were not in our cabin. Where did you end up?
Once Michael went down, it was just like... and it was just too much
yep.
for me.
My first night in Sweden was very interesting.
I had
right
earplugs
here.
And...
It's great. Varje gång jag ser dig
slår mitt hjärta dubbla slår. I feel
I've
pain,
heard it,
Daniel.
I've heard that pronounced seven different ways already.
I was really surprised to hear that this was the most visited
all,
tourist destination in
today.
Sweden. I actually think that's pretty incredible.
Wow.
Guys.
Oh, my God.
There's boxers. Oh, little kid boxers.
First impression of the moment I came in, it was kind of like an all-inclusive store, like a IKEA on steroids.
Aww.
I grew up next to the second largest mall in the United States, so I'm used to aggressive displays of commercial enterprise. This kind of felt like home.
It's like a Walmart meets Dollar General.
Oh yeah, it sucks to suck. Is it a calendar?
No. Ankomstid.
I have no idea what that says.
Kundmeddelande. Kära amerikaner, jag skulle vilja att...
Ja,
visst, sorry, just det, ni pratar inte.
Expression.
What are they saying?
It's a hunters.
It is!
A customer message. Dear Americans, this is your favorite Swedish host talking from above. You cannot see me, only hear me. I want you all to meet up at the second floor.
Love
look
that you can do
for the
this
green
you
sign
can film just
at
about
J10
anywhere in Sweden.
Saying
no permits.
Utemöbler grillar skog. And we'll meet up
is.
On the
Start
second
filming.
Floor for your first Swedish class.
School. We're looking for a school sign.
Michael.
School. All right,
okay, well, let's find it.
J2, so it'd be to the right. It's J10.
The only directions I understood were what he said the word school.
That's hilarious.
And second floor.
Right, we gotta go upstairs.
Was a little challenging to find the way inside of this mall.
Oh, it's a green sign that says school order.
There is no J10 down here.
I think we gotta go this way.
No, no.
Hur svårt kan det vara? Det här är utemöbler. Det här är grill. Är de på skoavdelningen då?
But look, there's escalators right here, and now we can go up ourselves.
It's the blind leading the blind. That's what we're doing right now.
We're not blind, we're lost.
We're lost, that's it.
You would think in a store this big, the second floor is gonna be the second floor all the way across the place. That was not the case. We went upstairs, got lost, back downstairs, and we had to go find the right section and then come upstairs to go to Anderson.
Good thing this wasn't a competition.
Volkomer, yips.
Welcome up?
Yeah, that's what it is. You nailed it.
Welcome up. Welcome.
Was something wrong with my directions?
This is the biggest store I've ever been in my life. There's so much stuff, I don't know what I'm seeing.
So, you had your first encounter with Swedes, and I think it's about time that I have a little small class with you about Swedes.
Okay.
How we are, and most of all, why we are. Are you ready?
Yeah, we're ready. Yeah?
Okay, so it's film time.
This is new. They didn't have that little film thing for us.
Welcome to Sweden, the land of the Swedes. Here are a few things you need to know about us.
Love it.
Our history of being farmers living in the countryside in houses far away from each other and in the outskirts of civilization have affected our social skills. We will do everything in our power to avoid talking to you or any other stranger. We won't say sorry if we bump into you because that could be mistaken as an invitation to small talk, and we avoid starting up small talk because we lack the knowledge of how to end them. We want to mind our own business and we cherish our alone time.
Egentid.
This might be the reason for Sweden having the most single households in the world.
The alone time, I find it to be very interesting. It's something that all humans need, but Swedes prioritize it. I feel like we as Americans...
Okay, so I got to pause here. This caused a big controversy in Sweden. It was in many newspapers, and people are upset about Swedes getting portrayed as this like cold, antisocial group. And I feel like the stereotype is probably lessening. I feel like we're getting, I don't know. Let me just say, my experience in Sweden was people were very generous, very kind, very warm. And then I think it's more they respect your space, and then they also enjoy their own alone time. But it's not like this cold, you know, hostile environment. At least that was never my experience with it. And
Americans should make that more of a priority.
A lot of Swedes are not happy.
We do not like conflicts, and we strive to find compromises. And so we always end up in the middle. Not too much, not too little.
Lagom.
Lagom is enough. Because of the urge for this lagom, we do not want to stand out. We expect everyone to be humble, never brag. Or, as it's written in the first commandment of the Scandinavian law of Jante, you are not to think you are anything special.
Jantelagen.
God dag.
God dag, förälder.
Therefore, we also take queuing, standing in line, very seriously. Everyone waits
Swedes
for their turn.
Very polite,
remember,
very
not
respectful.
To think you are anything special. We see ourselves as normal, sensible, and lagom in a world of people and countries with weird customs and irrational behavior. But recent studies show something else. This graph illustrates differences and similarities in values across the world. Most countries are placed somewhere around the middle, sharing similar views on morale, religion, and family, customs, and behavior. Except this runaway nation, Sweden. Being skeptical of religion and traditions, trusting authorities and institutions, while, at least until recently, being seen as a tolerant and open-minded country, is what placed us here. So, welcome to Sweden, the most extreme country in the world.
Yeah.
Cool.
That was very nice.
But your reflections on this?
I think what it's done for me is given me understanding of my family.
Oh, yeah?
For growing up in a family that's kind of closed off and reserved and very quiet. We don't talk, right? I didn't realize what they were doing was a part of their culture.
It makes sense why they didn't speak to us yesterday. Yeah. We do everything my possible not to say hello. Because like I don't know how to end the conversation.
Reserved,
we don't want this to just keep
stoic,
going on.
We have a way of leaving in the middle of a conversation. If you look away, we're gone. That's our chance.
We understand now it's because they don't want to engage in that kind of conversation because they don't know how to end it.
I don't know how much of the Swedish goodbye is a thing, but since I learned about it, I have definitely used it.
How am I doing?
There's a nice conversation. It's kind of over.
I had a fight with my wife. And then
there's the kids. As soon as I heard all about Swedish culture and the way they interact, I thought, this is my dad. The silence, the looks like this. I'm like, oh, okay, maybe this is like being at home in my childhood. I'm Matthew Soderberg. I'm 24 years old. I am from outside of Philadelphia, Pennsylvania.
I'm a little freaked out, but very excited, I would say.
My father is someone that's very important in my life, has always loved me and has always been there for our family.
I would not want to let everyone down here.
You won't understand.
My relationship with my father, I think, is one that's really rooted in love, but there's also a real discord and disconnect in that we struggle to communicate that to each other. For him, work and labor is the way of saying, I love you. I'm a much more verbal, kind of social emotional person who really finds connection through vulnerability with other people.
Go have a good time and learn something about
yourself. I like
Matthew.
I want to meet him.
It's a once in a lifetime.
I've not met him yet.
I'm pretty excited.
Yeah, it's great.
I need to learn to meet him where he is. And so I'm hoping that Sweden is an opportunity to learn why Swedish men are so silent and stoic and gruff, but also to give myself an opportunity to say I love you to my dad in a way that he would really understand.
So what is this?
That's the certificate of Carl Soderberg's citizenship for the U.S.
We have a trunk that my great-grandfather emigrated with. He wanted to build a life for his family in the U.S., and we are the products of that.
I could live in a different place,
so
with a different house and a different name.
Affect
this
generations.
Is a surreal feeling to finally be in this place with my feet on the ground where my ancestors are from. I would like an answer to why the men in my family are the way they are, because I am a Soderberg man,
those
and
walls
I'm
are
proud
cool.
to be one. But I've never fully felt like I belonged in that.
I hope you find what you're looking for, so your heart is warm forevermore.
I wish my dad was here with me because I don't think he'd say much, but I just know the excitement that he would feel, and I could feel that.
I hope you find what
yeah, it's pretty cool the impact
for,
that this has
so
on your family.
And
my dad and I watched My Special Day, and both of us cried together, and Grandma.
Dear Matthew, tombstones
really cool.
all over Sweden reflect ages of oppressive social immobility across the professions. Endless acres of graveyards full of titles that seem as important as personal names. And indeed, one social esteem depended for too long upon whatever station in life or guild one was born into. Career change was an almost nonsense concept. Your people did military service. Your family is rife with Swedish soldiers throughout the height and decline of the Swedish Empire. Most soldiers were given new names that reflected the places they served or their personal attributes. For example, your four-time great-grandfather, Jonas Svensson, was assigned the name Soderberg, and his son was given the soldier's surname Snig, handsome. Perhaps he was. But with Sweden's shift away from its role and self-identity as a war power, came a shift in your family away from soldierly service. One example is Gabriel Johansson, born 1802 and raised in a small soldier's cottage in Hemsjö, Småland.
Gabriel wanted to break free from his family's expectations to follow in his father's footsteps. He took a first attempt by apprenticing with a master frailsmith in Viaccio, but unsure, at 26 years old, he quit that and joined the military under the name Ud. 4 years later, he wanted out and resigned. He and his wife, Milena, became crofters, but the restlessness remained. That sounds like me and my family. There were name changes. He switched to Johan and added the surname Soderberg after his grandfather. Obviously seeking, he found himself with six children before he'd sorted it all out. But he'd already modeled a life outside military service, and many of his children dared to follow their own paths. Oldest son, Johan, shared his father's dream of becoming a craftsman, but found his way into smithing copper. He moved to Kristianstad in 1849 for an apprenticeship, and returned home a coppersmith 7 years later, working in Brokstad for the rest of his life. Your family still has examples of his work, such as a frying pan and a pot. I know we have these tools.
That's awesome.
That we have carried down from my great-grandfather, and so even if we don't talk about them, we hold on to them. Johan's children themselves continued to find their ways into creative work. The youngest of his nine children was Olaf, born in Vianga Parish in 1875. Growing up, he witnessed firsthand his sister become a well-known dressmaker in Copenhagen. I love that. And several of his brothers become skillful craftsmen. Olaf, too, dared to dream big and aspired to attend the prestigious farrier school in Alnarp. The local priest even sent a recommendation, but there is no record of him ever being accepted. Undeterred, Olaf's determination remained unshakable as he threw himself into blacksmithing. He apprenticed at a forge outside Lönsboda and honed his craft tirelessly there. In 1898, he married Ingrid, and together they had 11 children. In 1914, they relocated here, to Kaffetorp in Oppmana, where Olaf established his own forge and mentored his own apprentices. Olaf's oldest son, Carl, also learned the trade, but is said to have wanted to leave Sweden to avoid military service, which sounds like me. Most likely, he sought a new life, free from those lingering, old-world social pressures to just accept his lot in life. It's surreal to think about that as being my great-grandfather, and even though we lived in a completely different world, to know he was having those same feelings and those same fears about coasting through life without questioning anything. I mean, it's amazing to think that I'm one of a pattern.
Well,
I wouldn't say it's exactly the same, but I can see.
You see so many of these generational patterns in these stories.
Same place where my great-great-grandfather built a family home.
I mean, stuff that producers couldn't even know.
It's actually surreal. I really cannot believe that I'm standing in the exact same place. Carl traveled by himself to Port of Gothenburg on November 8th, 1916. He would have been 17 years old, and arriving at Ellis Island on November 22nd. This is a photo taken at the time of Olaf Soderberg's funeral.
Crazy.
And
can you
Carl
imagine
is on the left.
Jumping on a boat so
that's my
going to another country.
Who left Sweden.
You've probably never seen a picture of.
And Carl
no
married
media,
Lily.
No phone.
And one of their four children was Marvin Soderberg,
no TV.
Your grandfather.
Just
these are my great-great-grandparents, Olaf and Ingrid Soderberg.
Returned.
They look like they would have stories to tell, but you'd have to pull it out of them. Matt, as you visit your ancestors' graves, open the churchyard gate with care. It was crafted by your farjar's farfar, your great-grandfather, Olaf's own hands.
Oh, that's so cool.
And here, all this time later, it's still standing.
It's
the masterful smith remembered
cool.
in his obituary as follows. He did not have any modern machines, so he had to work hard to support his large family on a small income. However, he never complained, but instead showed a positive attitude towards life, contentment, and joy in his work. You'll find his gravestone marked Smed Smastaren, the master blacksmith. I just really love that it says Smed Mastaren, It's probably true to who he really was.
Look how beautiful that gravesite is and the cemeteries. And you'll see this all over Sweden.
Feels like a place they'd be proud to have someone like me come back and see.
The film almost doesn't do it justice. These cemeteries are lovely.
A lot of times you can be afraid that not being like everyone in your family means you're not part of a tradition. And I feel that sometimes with men in my family, whether I really do belong. But I see now that so many of us have questioned why we're here and what we're doing, and have chased something. It might be different for every one of us, but it's that same idea of wanting to find our own path.
That's amazing. Really cool.
Olaf Söderberg was a member of a volunteer fire department. He is the man in the middle with the hat. I see a larger picture of my father being here in Sweden because I understand the way that Swedes may not show their love through words or affection, but really through gestures and commitment.
It looks pretty serious.
If I'm learning anything from being in Sweden and reading my family's history, it's that family is not about being the same. Family is about finding your own path, and in fact, when that path gets hard, turning to one another.
Really well said. It's so crazy. Sitting there looking at those photos, walking with that big chest. That is such a good day. It is an emotionally exhausting day. Oh, nice smorgasbordta. We did not have that when I was there, but when I went back and visited family, we had lots of smorgasbordta.
It looks insane.
It's so good. And then I made one
cucumbers, orange slices.
For Christmas
this year. Take everything you could come up with. Throw it on the
set. This looks like when I used to
cook. There's lots of different
child.
Ways to make them.
Throw
some people get crazy artistic
and
with them.
See what comes out.
This is a typical dish to serve
turn these into
at
artwork.
Special occasions like
put a little
funeral
on top,
or someone retiring. Jam. Then you have it's a cake.
Okay. Here we go.
Lily, do you want
like
to
multiple
put
layers
our plates?
Of bread.
When I first looked at the whole spread, I was like, this is not something that I would probably consume. But the second you kind of cut through it and you see that there's bread in there, kind
of
makes it a little bit better because
mayonnaise.
Us Americans, like we love our bread.
Oh, my God.
Oh, that's not bad.
Yeah,
it's not bad.
It's like a sandwich with extra.
I kind of liked it. I'd say it tastes a lot better than it looks.
I really like it a lot. It's just like
he
having a little sandwich, tea sandwich.
Yeah.
It was perfect. Love it. I could eat those all day.
Skål och välkomna, hörni. Vad roligt att ha er här, tycker jag. Det här blir bra.
First day of school was really interesting. I enjoyed learning about some things about the culture. For me, having Swedish people in my life in the United States, it's helped me to understand them more.
Oh, this place looks ridiculous. Ridiculous. I really want to go here. Back house. And look at the view. That's so cool.
Kallbadhus, cold bath house.
Oh, I'm so jealous of this whole
experience.
The Swedish
Medical Society in 1814 declared that cold baths are good.
We went to a Swedish bathhouse in
like
Stockholm,
popped up
and I literally, the first
the
time I went, spent
small towns like Varberg,
6.5 hours there.
Resorts.
Second time was over 7.
And it's still popular, and not the least, it's nice when it's over. And also, hand in hand with this cold bath culture comes a naturist side. It's not uncommon to be nude. You know, it's an idea that your skin, your body feels good being
it's
close
to
the elements, the water.
I am super
naked
excited
in the
for
water.
Cold water swimming. I've been looking into cold plunging back home in the States. I've been wanting to buy a deep freezer that I can make
cold plunge,
so I can cold plunge
man.
Every day. So I'm super pumped for this.
I've been taking
although
ice cold
I
showers.
Say
I took ice cold
like
showers
this,
all
most
where we were swimming.
Like
it's invigorating.
Prefer
wakes you up,
to wear
gets
something
some blood
decent and nice.
Oh no.
Are you ready? So, are you ready?
Yes.
Yeah. This is good for you. Come on.
I definitely do believe that taking a cold bath and then maybe getting into a sauna is definitely healthy for like your whole entire body.
I was not expecting to see two men completely naked right in front of me, and all of a sudden, like, where do I look? Where do I look? What do I do?
Into the water we go.
Family TV, no big deal. And it's no big deal. It's hilarious.
Natural, it's fine, but then there's a penis right there, and you're just like, oh! MJ and Carl, they have balls. And you saw that really well today.
Oh, it's so good.
I don't know if I want to go in now.
We're like, oh, we're here now.
I feel like this is most people's greatest fear, being naked in front
being
of the crowd.
Being naked isn't a problem for me, you know. That's something
these two are doing it on in front of a couple million
people.
Naked, no big deal.
I'll probably leave this world naked, so.
Lots of respect.
It was freezing. I started like... It just felt like all my nerves were tingling.
Trevor and Eric and I went in a lake naked in the producer's room. I think they were disappointed they missed filming.
But it's not. Getting used to it.
My cold bath was, how do I describe it? Cold.
I'm not a Swede.
I consider that a success.
I can't. That was good enough. Good enough. From the hair. I got the hair. This half is obviously not Swedish. Down there. Swedish.
It actually did feel a lot better if you like stayed in there longer. Like my legs started to like actually kind of feel warm. I don't know if I'm more shocked
Pins and
by
needles.
The cold
oh, look
or by
how red
the naked.
Daniel
guys,
is.
I'm totally gonna keep doing cold baths in the future.
That's
this
cold
is like
water.
I've been immersed. I've been baptized into the Swedish culture, and now I'm sticking. It's gonna
I'd
be with
to
me forever.
Don't go for the sausage special.
I feel like
today.
Michael, you're definitely Swedish. And cold.
This has been by far the best experience I've had yet, because I learned that this is a big part of Swedish culture, and this place has been here for so, so long. And so it made me feel more at home and more welcome.
Really, that was fucking awesome.
Edit this
absolutely
for the,
fantastic.
For the channel.
I'm Swedish now. I felt like I had finally gone through the trials and tribulations of becoming a Swede. And when I got out of the water, I was like, I feel it now. I feel alive. I feel like a Swede.
This is the best thing I've done in Allt För Sverige ever.
So great.
But
when
we
walked back
here.
From our naked
first,
swim, one of the segment producers was like, are you swimming naked?
There won't be any competition today. No one is
now
leaving.
Now you are truly Swedish.
After this, how could we? Oh, no.
I'm very, very excited about that, because we have been, I mean, believe it or not, we have bonded. We love each other. We think that we're like the best group ever.
And yep. The second thing is there's
you
a
get so
message
close.
For each one of you
so
from
close.
Your Swedish relatives waiting for you.
I cannot believe that there's a message for me from a person living in Sweden that I'm related to. Like, what?
Yeah. So let's get going.
It's a powerful thing.
I just felt all this
these
energy
guys
in my
had
heart.
A great day.
I'm so excited right now to see what it is.
It's nice.
Okay, finally.
There's some pictures and there's our name.
Isn't this crazy, guys?
This is why we're here.
Yeah.
From far away, it kind of looked like me. So I thought it was a picture of me on the board, and I had no idea what was going on. And then I realized to see, like, a living relative that I can meet now. Gosh, it was amazing.
It looks like my
so
mom.
Beautiful.
Wow. This is why I'm on
so
this
we actually
adventure.
Got to meet
it's all about family
our relatives
and meeting
on this
family.
Day, but we had like
open?
No time with them.
That's a key word.
I was just feeling so overwhelmed with
boy,
gratitude
this
and love.
Heightened the...
It felt almost like a hug, you know?
The mystery.
So I just needed to take a moment.
Okay.
Oh, this is so cute. Welcome
so
to Sweden.
Nice.
We are delighted that you are participating in this competition. We hope it will go well for you and that we will see you soon. There are so many stories to tell and so many questions to ask.
I have been following Allt För Sverige for so many years, always wishing for one of my relatives to be on the show.
We wish
so
you all
nice.
The best of luck and sincerely hope that you win. We look forward to hearing from you after the show. Whether you win or not, we would love to celebrate with you.
We have hope and believe in you. You come from a family of fighters whose fighting spirit only gets stronger when facing adversity. Do your best and fight.
Nice.
The part that really struck me was the part about going through hard times, because I've just been through so much the past 7 years. My dad got sick, I got sick, my dad died. And knowing that my family in Sweden has also been through a lot means a lot to me, because it, you know, makes me feel like I'm not alone.
Enjoy the experience, and I am so much looking forward to see you.
Go for it, and good luck from the Rosgren and Carlson siblings. The one here in the middle, she kind of has a smile like my sister, Michelle. That's so amazing.
It's so good because there's not much to read. That's the best part. That is the quintessential Eckwurzel, where you're just like, hey, Carl, have a great summer.
Keep up the spirit. You can do it. It's worth fighting for. Be strong and love. Oh, that's so precious. Being on the bridge and being reminded that there were three generations of women that left this country, that left Sweden, and here there are three women that are still around, and they just seem so sweet. I don't know how to describe it. It's like one of the things, if I open up a card from one of my friends and I see how much thought they put into it, it means that I'm included, even though they don't even know me.
We believe in you. Oh. Sometimes you just need to hear that.
When it gets hard. Really cool. I know a lot of
big
the,
hug from Sarah.
People carried these letters. I won't say who carried them all over Sweden.
There are many of us. Who
and
are
that's pretty special.
She's so pretty. She has
that's intense.
Too.
Yeah, I gotta kill the music for. Don't want to get a copyright strike.
So to have my feet here. With a picture of a relative in my pocket, it means everything.
I'm gonna win this one for you guys.
So happy for everybody on this. It's just awesome. It was fun. I was talking with a lot of the cast about
the bloodlines go between us.
The stakes just got raised.
About these letters, and they really meant a lot to everybody.
My wishes and bring our families together.
Wait for me. It was cool. Cool to hear that experience.
To the summer studio is where we go to spend our weekends and our summer holidays.
It's
our
official.
Allt
För Sverige.
It doesn't feel like a holiday.
Back on air.
You're basically
season 11.
Pooping into a coffee filter.
Anything, just throw it in the box.
Competing against our friends is probably the hardest part.
Got the Swedish Emmy last year. See how this season goes. Will they win another Kristallen? But well done. Well done to the producers. I love the new cast. I get to meet the new cast, and most of them. And they are lovely people. I am very excited to see how their adventure goes and where they go. And anyway, this is really fun. It's really fun to watch this. And then, you know, when I did the show last season, I intentionally did not watch any of the past seasons, so I hadn't seen them before. I watched maybe 20 minutes of an episode from, I don't know which season it was, and turned it off and thought, no, I want to experience this for myself. I want it to be fresh and new. And so it's really fun to watch this new, you know, season from the perspective of having lived it, having been through it, kind of knowing what goes on behind the scenes. What you see is what you get. It's all very real, very raw, very just unique, incredible experience, very emotionally powerful. And I think we'll see more of that unwind. I appreciate you joining me and watching this with me. I'm going to put these out for each episode because why not? And, hope you're well, and I'll say hello, Horace O'Bro. This is Snart.